Let's talk about the diatonic semitonal. But before that, let's understand what the word diatonic itself means as a way to appreciate the scope of what semitones entail. Dia, Latin, which means through, and the tonic, you know, in this sense, sort of the guiding root. We'll come to that in a minute when we speak about the functional names of the scale degrees. And so remember that phrase, that phrase, scale degrees. This is going to be important very soon. So the tonic is really from tone, sort of like the home tone of whatever key you are in. So through the tone. This is, the diatonic is sort of like moving through a tonic to another tonic on the scale. Which scale are we talking about? The heptatonic scale, which is a seven note scale in common practice music, which in tonic solfa is do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti. I'll use this to explain, then I'll show you on the staff in a quick second. So this is a do. It is heading towards another do at the top. But these are the seven notes of the scale. Right adjacent, each of these notes, well, not all of them, are what we call, in this sense, let's call them accidental. If you are in this class, then you should know what accidentals are. So I won't labor this point. So from do, we are looking for D. From re, there's a re. Mi and fa don't have a semitone dividing them. From fa, there's a fi. From su, there's a z. On la, there's a li. So accepting this, these are the full 12 notes that comprise adoptive. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Right? So distinct them this way, that when I move from do through these notes to the do, this motion through the do, that is called the diatonic, because it is through the two tonics. That's a pretty graphical way to remember this. If you think of it this way, you probably never forget. Right? Now, if I include this in my motion, then it's becoming chromatic. Right? If I move from do to D, to re, to mi, to mi, to fa, to fi, to so, to z, to la, to li, then it means on your scale, you will have 12 notes. Right? And then, you know, maybe a 13 if you end up at the do here. In the diatonic, you will go through 7 and then end up on 8. Because this is the 8, that is called the octave. Is this clear? Another important point is that you must know that these notes belong together, right? You see that this has a do and this is a D, but there is a D and an E. Re, re, they belong together. Fa, fi belong together. So, zi belong together. La, li belong together. They share the same, you know, letter, at least at the beginning of these ones, right? And so there's a reason for this. This is important. These are degrees. So these two occupy the same degree. I'll come to that in a quick second when I draw them on the staff.